Hi there. This is Alicia from Royalwise.com. And today I was looking at PayPal and they have a brand new feature called PayPal Credit. And I spent some time exploring it and I'm intrigued, mostly slightly appalled, and mostly recognize that my clients are going to have a heck of a time trying to manage this. And so I wanted to show you how to manage your PayPal Credit with QuickBooks Online. So I'm looking right here at a PayPal summary and I can see that there's two different sections. There's now PayPal balance and PayPal credit. Now what's happening is that you're using your PayPal account to pay for your expenses, but it charges it to PayPal credit, which stores it like a credit card. The benefit of this is normally, if you don't have enough money in your PayPal account, what it does is it draws the money out of your bank and puts it into PayPal and then pays the expense. Instead, this is accumulating all of the money in one place so that you can make one payment at the end of the month for everything that you spent on PayPal. So in that sense, it does simplify the process. Where you have to be careful is in the accounting of this. So when I look at the PayPal balance, I can see these expenses right here. And when I'm in my QuickBooks or my QuickBooks Online, when you integrate it to your PayPal, you're going to see both the PayPal credit and the PayPal. And they're both going to have very, very similar lists on them. The PayPal is where you actually want to register the actual expense itself. So because you paid by PayPal, for instance, where this says Southwest Airlines, I would go ahead and make this my expense and assign a class if you need to. But in this PayPal account is where you want to add the actual expenses themselves. When you get to the PayPal credit, instead of the actual expense happening here, this becomes instead a transfer to PayPal because you're using this now to pay off the PayPal expense, which will then zero out your PayPal account. When I look back at PayPal, the next thing that I also see are credits. This is you paying off your PayPal credit card account, but paying it off through your PayPal. And this is where it gets a little confusing. Instead of paying an expense account, I'm going to transfer this to my PayPal credit card. And so this is now saying I'm paying off the credit card using my PayPal account. And I'll click transfer on that. So it's moving money back and forth and back and forth and back and forth. Now, the next part of this is actually paying off the bill itself. And so this is happening from your bank account. And so when I see in my bank feed the bank account payment, here is the paying off of the PayPal account. And so again, this is also going to be a transfer and it's from the bank to PayPal. And so this is when you're actually paying the PayPal credit card. So I'll make that transfer. So here's what the PayPal credit card statement looks like, and it shows the balance, and it shows the payment, and it's making the payment from the bank account. Now, I mentioned that what's quote-unquote easier about this is that it is accumulating all of your PayPal expenses for the month and allowing you to pay it all at once, so that you only have that one expense coming out from your bank account to the PayPal account. The drawback of this, though, is your terms on the credit card account. For the first 6 months, as long as you pay in full, there's no interest, and that's great. But as soon as you either don't pay or your promotional period is over, you're going to start paying $20 or 20%, 19.99% interest. And look at what they have here. There's a deferred interest calculation. And so it is actually accumulating deferred interest that you don't have to pay on until the end of the promotional period. So you are being charged interest for the ability to use this PayPal credit account, which is actually, I think, more confusing than just connecting your PayPal directly to your bank. So when all is said and done, I am not a fan of PayPal credit. So I want all my clients to be warned about this potential racket. This is Alicia from RoyalWise.com.